it comes. Miha is looking worse. Thank God he has his granddaughters here to help him out. They're sisters, 15 and 10. Engaging the enemy in combat so we could use his physiological data to improve the drones had always taken a toll on Mihai's body. But today, he was really showing his age. The drones we based on his data were being taken down at a faster rate now compared to when the war began. When Mihai found that out, he insisted on flying to the front lines to see it for himself. Sometimes he could be so stubborn. His age wasn't the only thing affecting his health. Over the years, flying at high altitudes for prolonged stretches of time had ravaged and poisoned his body. But he was a man of grit. Today, after 28 years, he saw combat again. If his flight suit still wasn't good enough to protect him, I can't imagine how many G's he hit today during the battle. As a pilot, he exceeds all our expectations. It's going to take a bit more tweaking before our drones can match his skill.
How penal is this penal unit, you ask? This place is a shithole. If you took the stink of all the corruption in the world, then corralled it all in one place, that would give you a pretty good idea of what the air smells like around here. We got all kinds of critters, too. Everything from flea-ridden guards, rabid dogs, and a mechanic doing the stretch for life. I can't forget the rats. Yeah, we got those. And some pilots who got their wings clipped, too. One's a great pilot, but a lousy thief. One's a gambler with no luck. And one's an anarchist with no balls. Their job here was to rev the engines on the fake runways. The idea was for Arusha's spy satellite to pick up the heat sig. Even though there weren't any real fighters here, it looked like it on their infrared. I bet you're wondering, if Arusha lost the war, how come they still have a spy satellite? Because someone over there was smart enough to train a bunch of computer nerds to hack into half of Osea's satellites. That's how come. Every now and again, I'd try to bust out. And every single time, those damn dogs would drag me right back. When I was in my cell, I'd hear this voice coming from the guards room. It was the Arusian princess rallying her people on the Arusian national broadcast. All us prisoners had become big fans of hers. You want to hear something funny? The guards were big fans, too. I swear to God, every time she was on the air, they'd turn up the volume on the radio and sit there listening. I could see how someone like her could win the hearts and minds of soldiers and workers alike. When the princess said something, you could tell she meant every word. Lately, she'd been having more fun with her speeches, and that made her seem even more charming. You could say her charm was like a virus. Whenever she'd point out stuff that was wrong with Osea, the prisoners in here went nuts. Hell, if anyone knew how messed up Osea was, it was the prisoners. They'd shout, "Burn Osea down." No way am I just gonna sit here and rot away in this hellhole. Dark blue. Instead of building fake-ass planes to trick Arusha, I'm gonna build one that'll really take off. You can count on that.
As proved by the failure of our previous strategy, the Arsenal Birds have bolstered the enemy's anti-air network. This will be difficult to overcome. However, we still need to get swiftly to the space elevator no matter what it takes. Someone there is counting on us. The hero of the Circum-Pacific War and the man who spearheaded the construction of the space elevator. Osea's former president, Mr. Harling. Mr. Harling was inspecting the elevator when the war broke out. He's been classified as missing since the elevator was taken over by the Arusian forces. However, according to the latest intel, a military officer accompanying Mr. Harling hid him inside the facility. Both are waiting for a chance to escape. Enemy anti-air radar network has been set up around the space elevator. It's likely a large squadron would be detected. We will send a single aircraft through the network and send in a rescue team soon after. A number of anti-air radars have been set up around the space elevator. However, our reconnaissance suggests their network is weakest along the southeastern coast of Selatapura. So we can elude the enemy's observation. There are a lot of rain clouds this time of year. Flying through the clouds will enable us to stay hidden from their radar. If you happen to be detected by their radar, we will be forced to abort the mission. The lone pilot who will head up this strategy is you, Trigger. After you bust through, secure the rescue craft's landing zone by taking out the anti-air weapons. Gollum and others will arrive shortly for support. Provide escort for Mr. Harling's craft after rendezvous. Good luck out there, everyone.
Aircraft preparations complete. Sortie ASAP.
Entering operation area. Imposing radio silence. We'll radio you, but you are not permitted to make contact.
If you're spotted, the mission is over. Stay out of enemy radar. Use of weaponry is also strictly forbidden. Okay, you're heading up the Harling rescue mission. The success of this mission depends on you. Good luck. rendezvous point. Good job, but stay focused.
Approaching the space elevator. Stop. nearby. Behind the gantry crane! Mr. Harling, stay right there! Jacob, we're hit! Incoming broadcast!
Sea Goblin, all survivors, respond. Is Mr. Harling alive?
They got the chopper head in the air, too! That was not all there!
Toward the space elevator. Shoot them down. Eliminate all enemy UAVs. Don't let up.
This is Colonel Johnson. Do you copy? I am Lieutenant Ed Harley. Rescue unit down. We'll look at the soldier who had this radio. Get Mr. Harley out of here.
Sir, we feel the same way. We'll figure something out.
Oh yeah, all mine.
That's about half. Pump up the rest.
We found that erosion transformer. His engines are on.
I heard you were in the Air Force, Colonel. Can you fly?
Better than Mr. Harley.
Blue. Three remaining. All squadrons be advised. The call sign is Mother Goose 1. I've sent the information via the data link.
Mother Goose 1? That's the best you can call it?
Frank! Frank! Golem Squadron, let's take it up a notch, okay?
Support. 5 minutes remaining.
Skykeeper, bogey's on my radar. Bearing 220.
Sighting confirmed as MQ-101. Forerunner for Arsenal Bird.
The big bird is coming, huh?
Mage, protect Mother Goose 1. Shoot down any UAVs. Gollum, intercept the UAVs.
Gollum 1 will kill. That last battle taught me a lot about those a-holes. Gollum 2, don't stray off on me. Always maintain element.
Stand by for my orders.
What about the lighthouse?
Yeah, I need the harbor. They won't be able to get home.
job.
I figured, but why weren't we informed?
The IUN can't coordinate between branches as usual.
Dark One Squadron, report.
Respond. Mage Squadron, assess the situation.
This is Mage One. I have Mother Goose One in my sight. Cabin's fine, but the cockpit's not looking so good.
Colonel Johnson, are you okay?
Don't worry about that. Just send help this way. I'm sorry. Can you stop me? Please.
Mother Goose One, respond. Mother Goose One.
Skykeeper, should we continue providing cover for Mother Goose One?
Of course.
Abandon on me. Lockdown hostile.
Mother Goose One is turning. What's going on? They're heading to the space elevator.
Flying at a steady altitude, and who's in control?
It's not the Colonel. Mr. Harling's the only one on board. Mother Goose One, respond! Mr. Harling, please respond!
We can't protect our objective if it sticks around here. Now's not the time to freak out, fellas. We've still got a job to do, so let's do it. Keep your mind focused.
Mr. Harling, we are not giving up on you. The UAVs are approaching Mother Goose One.
Let's go, Trigger.
Take him down now, Mage Squadron. 1 minute remaining. Mother Goose One, turn 180 degrees and exit combat airspace.
Mage Two! Mage Two!
Oh my god, Mother Goose One has been shot down.
Where'd the missile come from?
Mage 2 fired that.
There was no chance. A friendly missile hit him.
Verifying the situation. Stop speculating.
Friendly fire! I saw it!
Mother Goose 1 exploded in air. No one could have survived.
Looks like it tried to protect the elevator. The Rosian bastards, they just killed a hero!
Mage 1, was it Trigger? Trigger was the closest. UAVs were crawling all over our objective.
I told you to keep a goddamn eye on the hatchling.
It must have been a mistake.
Arsenal Bird is entering. All aircraft, withdraw immediately. Trigger, you can't fly for a while. You understand why.
The operation to rescue former President Harling has failed. Sadly, there is no hope he survived. Trigger, you are suspected of assassinating a former president. There will be an inquiry. There will most probably be a court-martial.